You are listening to Radio Maria Canada. We now present the Health Hub, hosted by Kathy Biasi.
Welcome to the Health Hub on Radio Maria Canada, exploring cutting-edge health and wellness information and therapies, helping you to take your health to the next level. I'm Kathy Biasi, your host, and I am an holistic nutritionist and a cancer coach. It's a wonderful thing when I hear of doctors prescribing regular exercise and movement for people because, as you know, as listeners of this show, exercise is essential for good health. And the trend towards templated circuit training and high-intensity interval training, or HIIT, seems to be taking the industry by storm because of both efficiency of time and magnitude of results. With us today is Bryce Henson, CEO of Fit Body Bootcamp, the world's fastest growing fitness bootcamp franchise. Bryce has nearly 15 years of experience in the fitness industry and owning two Fit Body locations. He is passionate about spreading fitness to the world. This is in addition to mentoring fitness professionals on how to grow their businesses and change more lives in their local communities. Bryce is committed to inspiring and educating audiences on how to improve their lives by improving their fitness. Through Fit Body's Bootcamp's worldwide transformation challenges, Bryce has overseen their global clients lose nearly 1 million pounds of weight, and more importantly, is helping offset the obesity pandemic and provide more health and life to his following. Bryce also co-leads Fit Body Mastermind Group, an exclusive coaching group for high-performing fitness professionals. Bryce was born in Atlanta, Georgia, grew up in Michigan, and has spent most of his adult life in California. He is a graduate of Michigan State University and speaks Brazilian Portuguese fluently, having lived in Florianopolis, Brazil. He holds citizenship in the United States and Portugal. He enjoys traveling the world and is a fitness expert, coach, author, and an inspirational leader. We're talking all things fitness, everybody. What are the benefits of circuit training and HIIT training, which is high intensity interval training? Why it's important to build lean muscle mass. So important to be building lean muscle mass, and why you should consider having a coach with you along your fitness journey. This is a great interview. It's important to understand the benefits of exercise beyond the aesthetics. I do hope you stay with us. We'll be back in just a few minutes to talk to Bryce Henson.
When you see broken beyond repair, I see healing beyond belief. When you see too far gone, I see one step away from home. How many times can one heart break? It was never supposed to be this way. Look in the mirror, but you find someone you never thought you'd be. I paid, and there's nothing you could ever do to lose.
with grace as one. So hold on, it's not the end. No, this is where love's work begins. I'm making all things new, and I will make a miracle of you. When you see broken beyond repair, I see healing beyond belief. When you see too far gone, I see one step away from home. You see nothing but damaged goods, I see something good in the making. I'm not finished yet, no. When you see wounded, I see mended. I see my child, my beloved, the new creation you're becoming. You see the scars from when you fell, but I see the stories they will tell. You see worthless, but I see priceless. You see pain, but I see a purpose. You see unworthy, undeserving, but I see you through eyes of mercy.
When you see broken beyond repair, I see healing beyond belief. You're not too far gone.
You are listening to Radio Maria Canada. We now continue with the program, The Health Hub, hosted by Kathy Biasi.
Welcome back, everybody. Today's show is being taped, so no opportunity for calling in. Please do follow us on our social sites. We are on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, and we are at The Health Hub RMC on all three locations. Bryce, welcome to the show.
Kathy, thanks so much for having me. Super excited to be here today.
Me too. We haven't had really like exercise type of show, and I think it's really an important space that we need to cover. More and more and more physicians, much to my greater happiness, are actually prescribing exercise. I've actually applied for something called a park pass, something or other. It's like a template prescription that I can give clients for exercise. So now, do you think that exercise is becoming more known? Or is it evolving just in the health space? What do you think? Where's the emphasis that this health craze is coming from, the exercise craze?
Great question, Kathy. I think it's a bit of both. It's certainly, I mean, there's science and, you know, our world is becoming more educated. And there's certainly a lot of stuff out there, some good, bad, and the ugly. But, you know, there's conclusive evidence just how beneficial exercise is for your body, for your, you know, hormones, for your, you know, the way your organs function, ultimately the way you live your life. And so I think generally speaking, there's just been a big trend towards health and fitness, especially, you know, after the COVID-19 pandemic, which, you know, did a lot of things. But my hope and what we're seeing is it opened up a lot of, world's population understanding the value of health, wellness, fitness, and really human movement. And then on top of that, as the industry has evolved over the last 10 years, which I've been part of it for a better part of 15, you've seen, you know, the industry evolve and really, you know, get better by the year. And specifically, you know, programs like circuit training and focusing on muscle building, also, you know, high intensity interval training, cardio. These are things that I particularly do, but ultimately the industry in general is progressing. So really, to kind of put a bow on it, Kathy, I think a little bit of both.
Okay, you've touched on a few things that we should probably circle back at. Class training versus personal training. Do you see it's one or the other, a space for both? Is class training more? I'm in and I'm out and I don't have to think too much. Where do you see that piece?
Well, I think to your initial or secondary question, is there a space for both? My big response is yes. And if you take a step back, actually, you look at the North America's health rate. Here in the States, we're just under 50% obesity. In Canada, you guys are a little bit better, but not by much. So really, why I articulate that is there's just a giant need for more people, even though the education is there, to take action on health and fitness. So whether you're doing it through a personal training program, through a group training program, through a class-based or session-based program, or on your own, ultimately you got to get moving. Now, from a results perspective, studies are showing that, you know, there is an issue with people doing it alone because there's lack of accountability in coaching. And let's face it, most people are not, you know, fitness professionals spending 8 hours a day designing their workouts and nutrition plans at home. And rightfully so, we're busy, you know, kids, work, and life. So because of that, you know, more accountability is needed. Otherwise, people just don't take action, unfortunately. But in specifically, you know, then the other side of the spectrum, personal training, one-on-one is incredible. You get a very, you know, focused professional helping deliver results. The drawback, though, is it lacks the energy, the, I guess, healthy competitiveness with something with a program like you can get within our program, and ultimately any class-based or session-based program, you get a better push. And the last thing there, you know, Kathy, as well, is just it's a fraction of the cost when really that's the niche of group training. So we've seen a big explosion of group training. And from my lens, I strongly believe it's the best because it provides the best results. It provides the best accountability support. It provides the biggest push and motivation because of that class group base. And when you're looking at it comparatively to the spectrum of personal training, you can do it a fraction of the price. So, you know, that would be where my perspective lies.
You know, circuit training has been given a bad name, a bad rap. We've come a long way with class-based training and the science behind class templates. I do HIIT classes all the time, which I want you to explain. But, you know, we're no longer in the 30-minute workout stage where you go to class and it's just about jumping around sort of thing. These class-based programs that you do are based in science and they are progressive, aren't they? So you're not just going and filling your time with great music and movement. You're going to a class, you are working within your own space. So this is what the thing that I like to point out too, because I do class-based workouts very, very frequently. And some people can get intimidated by them because they're a class-based, but it's still very much at your own pace. But I love the fact that you create these templates based in a progression for people, correct?
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. And to your point about the value or maybe bad rap of just the class base, you know, kind of just high energy moving around. Certainly there's value in that because, you know, you have to have a really strong cardio system. But the reason that, you know, that kind of old class style has basically been, you know, trickling out is because the lack of focus on the actual muscle building component. Mm-hmm. So with a circuit training program like that we offer with our Fit Body Bootcamp brand, not only do you get the high intensity interval training from a cardiovascular perspective, so you are moving, you are burning calories and you're working your cardiovascular system, but you are focusing on strength, and strength increases long-term, you know, health. It increases and restores metabolism. It reduces chronic risk and disease. It also strengthens, you know, your body, slims your frame. There's so many benefits for it. So to your point about the progression, any really circuit burning program that's worth its weight in gold has a progression plan and has an element of both cardiovascular and strength in their programming. Otherwise, you're really not serving the client at a high level.
And from my experience, you can adapt each and every piece of your circuit to people's abilities. So you don't have to go into your classes to be as a seasoned runner, correct?
Yeah, exactly. And I think that's also why the value of circuit training and really the foundation of the program is based around timing. So in any particular station, you know, it's not a number of reps where you ultimately, if someone's really fit and someone's not fit, the person who's going to fit, if you're just based off rep count, would finish very quickly versus the other person who's slow or maybe a beginner, it would take them a long time. It really creates inefficiency in the workouts because our program is circuit-based training, but timed intervals. intervals, you can have a super fit person next to a newbie or beginning, and they can still be getting an incredible workout because they're basically pushing towards the timing convention. And once that time interval stops, then ultimately they get a rest and they're moving on. And that way you can provide better results for two very different type of clients in the same program.
Mm-hmm. And high intensity interval, the HIIT training that we're talking about, can you just give us an explanation of what that is?
Yeah. And, HIIT training or high intensity interval, as you mentioned, is really taking a step back. There's two types of just generally speaking modalities in the fitness industry. Before we actually touch on HIIT, I'm going to circle back to what the opposite is a slow state, long form cardio. So when you think of, fitness endurance athletes or marathon runners or half marathon runners, ultimately when you're exercising that modality, you get your body up to a certain speed. And then you cruise at that cruising altitude for a long period of time, kind of more slow, steady. And then ultimately you kind of wind down. And, ultimately that is better than nothing, especially, moving your body, it's still going to have benefits, but it's not nearly as effective as the high intensity interval training. And actually, research has been shown and starting on this over, 100 years ago, citing from Japan as some of the first studies of how the Japanese used to train their athletes for the Olympic Games using this high intensity interval format, which really is short burst of really high energy, high intensity, where you're really working your cardiovascular system or your strength system in your body at full force or at a higher altitude. And then once that timing stops, then you slow it down to more of an active rest or recovery and then fire back again. And the best way I usually describe this as in terms of the benefit specifically to weight loss or a calorie burn as an example, take your car going down the road. If you're going on the highway, you get up to your cruising altitude, you go a long way, and then you get off. You actually get better gas mileage, or the opposite, meaning you burn less fuel. Okay. But if you take that same car and you go into the city driving, when you're stopping and going, you actually probably drive a shorter distance, but you actually burn way more fuel. But in this case, energy. And in this case, it's a good example to be burning energy and not. So that hopefully provides a little colorful analogy of the different types of training and really the benefits of circuit training versus steady state cardio.
The other benefits too are that it's engaging. You're always thinking, you're always moving. And the amount of time, how long are your classes?
Yeah. So to your point, actually 30 minutes is our secret, sauce and spot on it. So that's the beauty of our program as well, is you don't have to, science has shown, you don't have to spend an hour, 2 hours, at the gym, like it was previously thought. If you actually just dedicate yourself a half an hour a day and get a very focused, intentional, progressive workout that's working both strength and cardio, you can get an incredible workout. You can also get incredible health result and aesthetic result all in one. So that's the reason and methodology of why our workouts are 30 minutes. Also, the last point on that, Kathy, and to put a bow on that, it also just depends on the type of result that you're trying to get your client. So our clients and our dream client, our avatar we call Mrs. Jones, is not a high performance fitness athlete. She's not trying to shave off a second or 40 to make the NFL combine. She's looking, she's just an average, ordinary person, has a couple kids, has work, has a husband. She probably hasn't been to the gym in years. She probably doesn't love working out, but she knows she needs to for the health benefits, for the aesthetic benefits, for the confidence benefits. So that also from a 30-minute circuit with that focus, creates more long-term sustainability, because let's face it, you can gear yourself for a half an hour. And if you keep on stacking those wins over the next 3, 6, 9, even 12 months, you're going to see big results.
And the variability of exercise, one of the things that people talk about is, what exercise is right for them, what they like doing. And, first of all, we want to start with movement. Okay. So if you have someone in there who hasn't done a lot of movement, as you were speaking to, and as we talked about before, you get interest, you get variability, you get engagement at each level as you progress in a circuit. And this is why I love the circuit training, because you don't plateau. You don't plateau at I've done it. I've reached my limit. There's always that extra kick. There's that extra level. There's that extra hill. And so it's engaging. And, no matter what level you're at, if you do a circuit, this is my opinion, you can certainly correct me. If you do a circuit well, you're exhausted at the end of it, no matter what level you're at. And I think that that's a great feeling for people to have.
Oh, amen. Absolutely. And, you know, it's all about checking or stacking wins and checking up boxes. And once you start putting one foot in front of the other, you start building off that, to your point. I mean, 30 minutes, do not let that fool you. By the time you're done with that, especially if you go full force and as you continue to progress, you're going to be a hot, sweaty mess. You're going to be exhausted and you're going to feel so accomplished. Mm-hmm. And you can realize, oh, wow, I can do that again tomorrow. And again, once you start stacking wins over the long term, you feel very accomplished. And I love this quote by Tony Robbins, which I'll put a bow on: progress equals motivation. So when, you know, client can actually prove to themselves they can get through a circuit, they can get through a full session, and they can keep on stacking those wins, you know, maybe they're not to the result they want to be within a 30-day window or a 60-day window, but when they start seeing progress, that actually increases their motivation, which long-term creates compliance and success with the program.
Absolutely. Here's another quote I like: just show up. Just show up. That's the hardest part of the workout, is showing up, getting your mind in the right space. Now, your avatar is a woman. Is that because your clients are mainly women?
That would be the reason, actually. And we do have male clients brand wide. About 75 to 80% of our clientele are women, and about 20 to 25% are male. I'm going to give myself a hard time. Guys are usually a bit hard headed when it comes to coaching and being open to support and being vulnerable. So I think most times, and of course, this is the generality and there's exceptions to every rule, but most times women have more of an open mindset of coaching and community, and ultimately have less vulnerability around this, even though, you know, women come in scared and nervous and thinking, oh, everyone's a fitness model in the session, which is the absolute not the truth at all. But because they're a bit more open-minded, especially to the group environments, the coaching, what we find is we're able to attract a lot more women in our program. And then, of course, a lot of our clients, and we still market to men as well, but we find that many of our male clients are husbands or family members, the women clients, once mm-hmm. they kind of see on the sidelines their wife or their spouse getting incredible results after a few months, then they're thinking, oh, shoot, can I join that for only a half an hour a day? That sounds amazing.
Yeah, you've just capsulized our family. Exactly. Now, coaching. How much coaching is there actually done within a type of HIIT class or a circuit class? Do people get hands-on, or is it more of a general thing? Leading to the question, can you get more injury because you're kind of left on your own, or do you have a close eye on who you're working with?
Oh, incredible question. And, you know, our program, our brand here at Fit Body Bootcamp is in what we kind of advertise or showcase, is we are personal training in a group setting. So earlier you mentioned, you know, the high music kind of music filled class space, you know, workouts where it's just really movement and energy, which is certainly important. But those class based workouts, when you only have one instructor, everyone's doing the same movement, you really can't provide form coaching. You can't really provide muscle, growth and focus on that modality either. So that's why, you know, having a circuit training with multiple coaches on the floor, and we have two coaches within our brand. We have the mic coach and we have the floor coach. And the mic coach is actually that person leading the workout, kind of being assertive, providing directive to the different stations, providing energy, calling names to our clientele, creating that warm, energetic, atmosphere. And then we have the floor coach. The floor coach's sole job is to be in the trenches, build relationships, watch form, focus on form, make sure our clients are executing these exercises very safely and effectively. So to that, to your point, injury can be mitigated. Now, is there a chance for risk? Absolutely. I mean, walk outside and, you know, get injured and hit by a car, knock on wood, there's risk in any particular situation. However, when you have, you know, good supporting a program with coaching your form, then you can focus on muscle building and feel empowered to do it very safely.
So in a successful circuit training, what is the prototype? How many stations? Are you on a treadmill? You on a rower? Free weights? What does it do?
Well, I think big picture, there's a lot of different variety of you know, types of programs and trainings. Some of our competitors use treadmills as an example. We don't actually. What we found is, typically speaking, our modality, and actually instead of going to the station work first, we actually, I'll kind of high level backtrack a little bit in the three modalities. So we have three types of workouts that we progress our clients on. One is called the strength workout, which is really a resistance-based focused workout. The other is a metabolic conditioning workout, or cardio workout for short. And then the third workout is a classic workout, which is really an even blend of both, both cardiovascular and resistance training, and both are needed. And for the metabolic conditioning, the cardio workout, you're still actually progressing from a strength perspective, but it's just the majority of focus for that particular workout. It's cardio based. The opposite is true for resistance. You still do metabolic conditioning or cardio work within that workout, but the majority of focus is on the resistance element, lifting weights, et cetera. And the classic is an even blend of both. So those are the frameworks of the workouts. And then specifically, depending on the day, it just really depends. The variety is actually, creates muscle confusion. It's the spice of life. It's more mentally stimulation. So we do like to mix it up. We have, a few different formats, anywhere from 4 stations at the minimum, upwards of 8 stations, various time frames. So it all just depends on the programming for the lead or the head coach of that particular week, as our programs are created on a database on an individual, but ultimately a database for that specific location, and swapped out. So long-term, that variety really helps get our clients long-term sustainable results, both physically and also mentally as well.
Mm-hmm. The mental piece of constantly moving and changing up is underplayed, I think. And afterburn. So this is a big thing with HIIT training, is the afterburn. It's not just the calories you burn when you look on your Fitbit or whatever, you look up, you see the calories you burn. There's an afterburn, which is also not really talked about or understood. Can you talk about that?
Yeah. So afterburn is kind of the layman's terms, if you will. The, I guess, geeky scientific term is called EPOC, which stands for excess post-exercise oxygen consumption. And really, it goes back to actually the strength training and how important that is, because even at high intensity interval training, cardio, if you just do cardio, you're going to get a better result. Your cardiovascular system is going to improve in its health and its fitness. And you're also going to burn more calories if you're doing interval training versus steady state cardio training, just from a cardio perspective. But even at high intensity interval training, if you only focus on the cardio and you do not do strength-based training, you're not going to get that EPOC or that afterburn that we refer to. And really, that afterburn is designed, it really comes from when you actually do resistance training. What you're doing is actually tearing the muscle fibers apart from your body, and then you're rebuilding them denser, which creates more of a lean look. They actually burn, and ultimately, muscle is metabolically active tissue. So when you build lean muscle mass, what happens is you actually burn more calories at a steady state. So that's really, if you focus on resistance training and you get, some good, lifts in and resistance work in your particular strength training exercise, your body can burn calories up to 36, even 48 hours afterwards, really to hit that afterburn or that EPOC, if you will, within known in the fitness community.
You made an important comment there. Muscle is metabolically active. And I don't think people appreciate the depth of health value that having a developed muscles, developing the musculoskeletal system has for overall health. We're going to take a quick pause and we're going to come back to this. We're going to focus on this area the second half, because a lot of interesting research is coming out about, we talked about fascia on the show a number of times and how it used to be just discarded tissue in the doctors are doing examining bodies and so forth. And now they've come to realize the importance of the fascia tissue in the system. Same with the muscle systems. I think we're starting to realize that they're far more than just what helps us move and keep things in check down there. So we're going to take a quick break. And when we're going to come back, we're going to talk to Bryce about the real importance of developing a strong muscular skeletal system. We'll be back in just a few minutes, everybody.
Another heartbreak day. Feels like you're miles away. Don't even need no shade when your sun don't shine. Too many passing dreams roll by like limousines. It's hard to keep believing when it pass you by. And bye. I know your heart been broke again. Oh, I know your prayers ain't been answered yet. Oh, I know you're feeling like you got nothing left. Well, lift your head. It ain't over yet, ain't over yet. So keep walking,
finished yet. Hold on, hold on, he'll get you through this. Hold on, hold on, these are the promises I never will forget. I never will forget. So hold on, hold on, the Lord ain't finished yet. Hold on, hold on, he'll get you through this. Hold on, hold on, these are the promises I never will forget. I never will forget. I know your heart been broke again. I know your prayers ain't been answered yet. But it ain't over yet. It ain't over yet. So get up and move.
You are listening to The Health Hub here on Radio Maria Canada, a Catholic voice wherever you are. To contact us and be a part of the show, email thh@radiomaria.ca. We now continue with the program. Here once again is your host, Kathy Biasi.
Well, welcome back. We are going to continue our conversation with Bryce Henson, the CEO of Fit Body Bootcamp. We ended off the last segment talking about muscle, and really, it's a lot more than aesthetic. We're not just building muscle to look pretty, to have, the perfect body, which again is a whole other show. But the importance of muscle is really coming to the forefront in health. In chronic disease, chronic illness, one of not the underlying, but one of the things that is going on in the conversation is insulin resistance. We also talk about hormones, things like that. Can you give us just a broad picture of where the health piece of muscle building comes into the workouts?
Yes, incredible question, and certainly a conversation that needs more discussion. And, let's face it, taking a step back, the aesthetic, that can be important to people, and which is great. You want to look good, you want to feel good, you want to have that level of confidence. And, being very candid with you and our audience, when I first got in the fitness industry, I actually initially was looking for a better physique and better aesthetic feel, which I got from focusing in on circuit training and muscle development and cardio, high intensity interval training that we talked about. But ultimately, what I also realized is, while the aesthetic was great, the benefits long-term of health and fitness have really what's kept me in the game for going on 15 years. Now, specifically muscle building, this is so important, especially since our dream clientele are women. And, we've hit the importance of just generally speaking muscle, the benefits of focusing on this. We'll provide a little bit more guidance, but really I want to kind of take a step back and really debunk a myth, because a lot of times, at least in, working with our clients, many times, what we find out is women are, and not all, it's a generality, but true many times, is that women are afraid to lift heavy and lift big weights because they're going to get big and bulky like the Hulk. And the reality of the situation is most guys don't have enough testosterone in their body to really make muscle gains like the women are envisioning. And in fact, when you build lean muscle, what happens is you actually create metabolically active tissue, which is incredible. You burn more calories at a steady state, and you actually get toner. When you burn more calories, you look leaner and you look toner. So it actually has the opposite effect, typically speaking, of getting big and bulky. It actually leans you out and makes you look toned. So that's from an aesthetic perspective, but really from a long-term health perspective, again, building muscle improves your long-term health. It increases your metabolism, really hits that afterburn that we talked about. It strengthens your body. Okay. It strengthens your core. It boosts boosts your energy. It also boosts your overall feelings of wellness. Another really important focus of muscle building is really its effects on inflammation. And anti-inflammation is really, really important because especially as we age, our bodies get more inflamed. So by focusing on exercise and specifically muscle building, what this does is it activates your sympathetic nervous system, and your sympathetic nervous system it helps increase your heart rate, helps moderate blood pressure. It also helps breathing rate. So the inflammation in your body will actually decrease by focusing on exercise and muscle building. And the last big thing it does specifically that I want to hit on is just working on your hormones. And you kind of made a mention of this as well. But when you work out, when you exercise, when you focus on building lean muscle, what happens is you feel better. Okay. Your endocrine system, ultimately, which is in charge of your hormones, regulate hormones like cortisol and melatonin and insulin and your sex hormones, T3 and T4 as an example, those are your thyroid hormones. And then your sex hormones, progesterone and testosterone. So by working out and lifting weights and really building resistance training, you're helping your hormonal balance in your body. So for cortisol, as an example, a lot of people, if they have a lot of stress and anxiety and do not work out, their cortisol level increases, which eventually whacks up the immune system. They get anxious, they get stressed, they get sick quicker. So by lifting weights and focusing on muscle building, you're actually helping control your cortisol levels. That also, the flip side is melatonin. Melatonin is the hormone that actually helps you sleep better at night. So this is why when you talk to people who work out, they typically have more energy during the day and they crash harder at night. They get in deep sleep because their melatonin is ultimately activated better. Your thyroid, between your T3 and T4, this is a big hormonal issue for a lot of people, but specifically women. And again, studies show when you focus on resistance training, when you build lean muscle, your hormones are able to, organically and naturally moderate themselves better. Now, certainly if people have really big imbalances, it's still highly encouraged you to go see your professional, et cetera. But these are just high levels, some big, big value bullet points, aside from the aesthetic, which I hit on, but really from the health perspective, from the overall benefits, from the inflammation, from the hormones that make you feel better, which really provides you a better quality of life.
Absolutely. And there is nothing wrong with wanting to look better. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. And as you say, once you go in and you see all the other benefits of exercising and movement, it is extraordinary. And things go under the radar. When you're talking about inflammation and so forth, again, the one thing I peel back to a lot that I'm really starting to study more is insulin resistance. And building that lean muscle mass really does help improve insulin resistance. We're talking about blood sugar, diabetes, and all of that leads to inflammation. And as everybody knows who listens on the show, inflammation is the underlying factor in most, if not all, chronic disease. So, there's just endless pathways and circuitry we can talk about when it comes to exercise and the importance of it. But circling back again to the circuit training and so forth and the anti-aging aspects of this type of training, if someone was in their 60s and decided that they listen to the show, they become inspired, can they still develop the lean muscle mass through circuit training? Is this something you needed to start in earlier in life? Is there an entry point for everybody?
It is never too late to get started. And that's the beautiful news. Now, that said, the longer you wait, the harder it is. And that's just the truth. But ultimately, there's always an opportunity to better your health. And, and especially as you get older, it becomes more important, especially we really hit on today's show, the importance of muscle building. Well, what happens with, age and maturation is your muscles start to atrophy. So when that happens, ultimately that causes a lot of issues in your body, a lot of things that we just discussed in terms of hormonal imbalances, inflammation, et cetera. But ultimately, as time goes on, it's even more important to build lean muscle mass. To answer your question, Kathy, no, it's never too late. The time is now. And it might be a little bit slower start. But again, I would highly encourage you, especially if you're 60, you haven't worked out in a while, by going on your own, by joining the YMCA or local club without any guidance or coaching. I think it's going to be a very big challenge, just knowing human nature. what I would recommend to that person is reach out, do some diligence. Maybe it's best to get a one-on-one personal trainer start before you can find a program. We actually have a program called Fit Body Forever, which is targeted towards, you know, people in their later part of life, in their late 50s, 60s, 70s, even 80s, which is a very specialized program, be a home run if it's a Fit Body Forever program is in your area. But regardless, getting the help of a fitness professional will definitely make a huge deal in your long-term health.
Well, yeah, we pay professionals to do many other things in our life, right? And exercise isn't just, you know, something we can just, you know, throw the shoes on and get out there. You can injure yourself. The flip side of this is that when you're exercising under care and you're building that muscle mass, you may find as you're aging, those little aches and pains are decreased. They are supplanted with other aches and pains of muscle stress and so forth, but those are nice pains to have. They really are. And, you know, just to, as you say, put a bow on things when it comes to aging, you know, two out of, you know, the three main pillars of a healthy aging person is community and movement. And these circuit training groups provide that. They really do. They are not, from my experience, they are not a competitive environment. Unless you're competing with yourself, they're supportive. They're, you know, you're there with like-minded people, and it's a wonderful way if you're looking to get a community to join some classes like this and reap the benefits on so many different fronts. So it's a wonderful, wonderful place to really move you into this next phase of life. So a very, very, you know, I just wanted to point that out to you. And with stress and everything, of course, it's wonderful to be involved. Now, do you offer courses online or do you have to find a studio? How does it work within your specific company?
Yeah, great question. But Kathy, before you do, you just had such a great point that I want to hit. We've obviously been talking about the health benefits, you know, of your body in terms of, you know, exercising. But one thing you just mentioned as well, in terms of the benefits of the relational aspect, you are so right. Studies always show the most healthy people, the most active people, the most happy people who live the longest lives, typically speaking, have a very good support network compared to the opposite or the latter. So that group training environment just is a wonder on building community, building relationships. And yes, from your body perspective, but also your mental health, your longevity, and your life expectancy. So that's just an incredible point that I want to, you know, hit on.
Well, you know, if you've ever done a race or you've ever done some of these classes and you're doing competition type of classes, and again, within your own like benchmark-ish types of classes, I've experienced people, you know, they cheer you on. So if someone's finished beforehand or in a race, you know, it's not like every man for himself. There's such a sense of community where it's the last man has to make it across. You know, we're all a group, last man makes it. And it's just a wonderful feeling because you get that accomplishment, that personal pride, and then again, this community. So I think it's very important. So yeah, sorry, Bryce, onto your company.
Yeah, no worries at all. But to answer your question, just about, I think your initial question was, which I diverted, was, you know, what are the modalities, how to find us? You know, typically we are a brick and mortar, you know, franchise system. So we do have online virtual sessions, which has been an innovation of COVID. But how you would, you know, reach out and get sorted on that is, you know, go to fitbodybootcamp.com, and which is our global site, and you can type in your address. We're based in North America. So about 90% of our locations here in the US, about 10% of our locations are in Canada, but that ranges from BC all the way to Ontario. And ultimately, pull up your local Fit Body, even if there's one not in a very close proximity, I would still put in an express of interest or opt in. And then once you, you know, ultimately get some communication back from that studio, just ask them about their online protocol and they can provide you their virtual workouts, et cetera. So that would be the option for people that don't have a studio close to them. But of course, the big home run would be if the studio is within a handful of miles from your location. And again, we have hundreds of locations throughout North America. You can reach out, you know, ultimately we have an intro or trial offer, which is typically, it depends on the studio and the time of year for whatever promotion. So you can come in, try our program and see if it's a great fit for you.
Well, through COVID, I did, you know, we were shut down here in Ontario for quite a while, online classes all the time. And again, there is a sense of community in that too, because it's like a big Zoom class. So you're still getting the benefit of community, even if you're not rubbing elbows with people. And, you know, again, to expand upon what your company does, do you train your own coaches? Do, you know, are you just having, not just, but are you having personal trainers applying for jobs, or how does it work? Are you working with professionals as well?
Yeah, great question. So, you know, we are a franchise-based system. So all of our locations are independently owned and operated. But here at HQ, our headquarters, we have an extensive training protocol. So when we're, I guess, you know, bringing on coaches, we have a 12-week onboarding training protocol that, you know, teaches everything from human movement, from fundamentals, from mindset coaching, behavioral change, because really, you know, Kathy, a lot of success in fitness and in life is actually just adaption or behavior change. So, you know, that 12-week protocol is the onboarding, and then we have continuing education. So we provide the platform and the training across all brand wide, but each individual location owner of the studio is responsible for recruiting and hiring and taking, you know, their coaches and interns even to start, you know, through the proper training. So that way, each individual studio is stacked with a team of anywhere from 4 to 6 or 7, you know, coaches, depending on full-time or part-time, depending on the schedule. And really there is a service to all of our clients within that community. And that's really how our training protocol like starts back end and really gets distilled across all of our locations worldwide. And that way the client and our avatar, we call Mrs. Jones, can walk into any Fit Body Bootcamp location, be incredibly supported by a knowledgeable coach, by a coach that has access to continued training and education to be able to provide them a great, incredible experience.
So is there a continuity between each of the franchises? Is the template sent from above and disseminated to everybody, or does each studio, they're kind of on their own when it comes to creating the exercise program?
We actually have what we call a workout builder, and we invested hundreds of thousands of dollars at this protocol with very educated master's level people that have been educated in human kinesiology and exercise movement. So that is our database, which is incredible because it provides structure, guidance, and consistency across the board. However, different than most franchise systems, it also provides flexibility and a little bit of freedom within the framework and parameters of that individual coach or owner to provide the workouts. And what we've learned over the years is it's important to have a consistent product in a safe program modality designed by high-level experts, especially as we're an international brand. But at the end of the day, the foundationally, as long as that framework is clearly established, what we also learned that gets the clients the best result is coaches love to put their own creative spin and have some buy-in and selection with their workout. So the workout builder, the template that we've created, has that framework and structure, but also has the ability for each coach to personalize or, you know, create their own specifications to their workouts. And that way they really can get behind it. They can believe in it. They can really push their clients to limit, you know, assuming that client wants to go there and get the best result as humanly possible.
Mm-hmm. Now, Radio Maria and the Health Hub is here in Ontario, and you said you're moving into Canada. Do you see that picking up speed here?
Well, it's been especially challenging the world with COVID, and especially for, you know, our friends up north in Canada. Mm-hmm. So that's been a really big challenge just in terms of government protocols of the last 2 years. But things are getting better, which is incredible. And again, we have 10% of our locations already operating in Canada. We actually have a franchise business coach based in Ontario or near a suburb there, Guelph. And then we have on the other side of the country, actually our director of internal marketing, a good friend of mine, Joel Kokas, is based in BC, just in the suburb of Calgary, owns a few locations there. So we do have a footprint in Canada, but that's something that we want to continue to move full force at, especially as we, you know, wind down from the COVID-19 pandemic and things continue to open up. That's our focus, to really make a bigger imprint on North America in general, but also specifically Canada.
Wonderful. Looking forward to seeing studios around us. So give us your website again, place where we can contact you, social media, if you want to throw that out.
Yeah, the best way brand-wide is our website, fitbodybootcamp.com. Would be the best way to find our brand in general, learn about, you know, our modalities, what we offer, the coaching, also nutrition, really support in general, and, you know, access to local studios. And then for me specifically, I would love to continue to add value to Kathy and your audience, and my social media channels, including my website, is Real Bryce Henson, not to be confused with fake Bryce Henson, but Real Bryce Henson, and then .com is actually my website, but that's also my, all my social media as well. So that's where you can find me.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for joining us. I really enjoyed the show. I think it's an important segment. Exercise can come in many ways, shapes, or form, but, you know, a lot of us are looking for that structured piece that offers variety and a good bang for the buck as far as value and time. So thank you so much for joining us, and congratulations on your success.
Kathy, it was such a pleasure. You were super sweet, very knowledgeable, and make an incredible host. This show has a ton of value, and thank you so much for having me on.
Oh, thank you very much. And everyone, will talk to you next week on The Health Hub.
Have been listening to The Health Hub, hosted by Kathy Biasi, here on Radio Maria Canada.